Hello everyone, welcome to Dress My Craft. This is design team member Jayashree this side. Today, we'll alter an embroidery hoop using Dress My Craft's pattern paper. Before we dive into the tutorial, do subscribe to our channel if you haven't already and hit the bell icon to never miss a video from us again. To begin with, I am using a 9-inch embroidery hoop. I am going to cover the whole hoop with chalk paint in the color sheepskin. You may also use heavy gesso, white or black for the same. Next, I am using Dress My Craft's Whimsical Hues pattern paper. It has beautiful floral designs in the shades of greens and pinks. It also has a unique vintage effect pattern paper design in it, along with a design with cutter parts in the end. I have selected two designs and I am marking the outer circle with pencil on one of the paper, which will be my base paper. I am now cutting out the circle. On the next design paper, I am marking the inner circle with the help of the hoop and cutting it out too. Now, I have made another circle on the same second circle at a gap of 0.75 inch from the edge. I am cutting the inner circle as well. Now, we are left with the border of the circle. Using the Tim Holtz paper distressor, I am going to distress the inner edge of the circle border. Since I want to curl up the inner edge of the circle border furthermore, I am spraying some water to make the paper easy to roll. Once done distressing, I am using the Ultimate Craft Glue from Dress My Craft to adhere the base circle on the back of the embroidery hoop and the circle border onto the base circle. Also, after adhering the base circle, cut off any extra paper hanging outside of the hoop for a clean and finished look. Now, using Dress My Craft's paper trimmer, I am cutting the note cards on one of the design paper. To know more about the Dress My Craft paper trimmer, do check out the full review video, the link to which is given in the description box below. I have selected three note cards with which I will make background layers for my main image. Now, before I add any texture and colors to the background, I am applying a thin coat of clear gesso, which will prevent any seepage of water and paints through the paper. Once dried, I am using Dress My Craft's Mixed Media Stencil, which has a very intricate and beautiful script design on it. Using texture paste, I am adding some script design on the base circle. Next, using crackle texture paste and randomly adding some paste on the border of the embroidery hoop and around the stencil area on the base circle. While the texture paste dries, I am distressing the edges of the note cards. I am also inking its edges using Distress Oxide ink in the color Walnut Stain. Once the texture paste has dried, I am now using Impasto paints to add some background color. I am using the colors Raspberry, Crimson and Lemon Peel for the same. I am simply taking out a drop of paint on my Dress My Crafts thick craft mat. It is a must have for all the mixed media paper crafting and card making artists. Now I am spraying some water on my base paper and adding just a little color at a time. I am starting with lemon peel color and covering the distressed edge of the circle border with it too. Next, I am adding raspberry color and blending the two colors. I am adding more water to move my colors. Lastly, I am using the crimson color on the circle border and removing the excess with the help of tissue. I am also adding the three colors on the embroidery hoops border. Moving on, I am using Whimsical Hues motif sheet and fussy cut out some floral elements to add to my hoop. For embellishing my hoop, I am using tons of fussy cutouts from both the motif sheet as well as the pattern paper itself. Apart from that, I am using some clay molds, mulberry rose flowers, and a chipboard frame. I am also using some die cuts made using Dress My Crafts Tropical Swirl die set and leaves using Dress My Crafts Foliage and Leaves No. 6 die set. While I try to figure out which element to place where, why don't you hit the thumbs up button on the video if you're liking the tutorial and share some love with us. Once I am satisfied with my placement, I am beginning to adhere everything in its place. Starting with the note cards which I am adhering using Dress My Crafts 12mm 3D foam tape. Next, to adhere fussy cut out elements, I am using Dress My Crafts Ultimate Craft Glue along with 3D foam tape in some places. Next, I am adhering the clay mold on the edge of the hoop with my hot glue. I am now adhering the mulberry roses along with leaf die cuts. These leaf and foliage die cuts are very versatile and add so much interest to any project. Dress My Craft has a wide variety of leaf and foliage dies, so do check out their website. You may use the whole of the leaf die cut or tear it in pieces like I am doing here. I am also adding the swirl die cut tucked behind the clay mold frame which I have adhered using craft glue. I am now adding a cage fussy cutout element onto my mold frame using 4 to 5 layers of 3D foam tape to add dimension. For the main focal image, I have cut out this image of a lady from the pattern paper itself, which I am placing behind the chipboard frame. Now, using Dress My Craft's Dots and Stripes motif sheet, I have fussy cut out a small butterfly, which I am placing on the cage using hot glue. I am now using some frosted sugar powder from Dress My Craft and randomly adhering it on the flowers using Dress My Craft's Ultimate Craft Glue. I am also adding some micro pearl beads from Dress My Craft here and there on the base to add some more interest. Lastly, I am adding some bows made with Dress My Craft's green satin twine tucked behind the floral arrangement and some sequins in the color Shabby Chic randomly here and there. This completes our alteration of the embroidery hoop using the amazing Dress My Craft products. I hope you liked this tutorial and project and will give it a try for sure. Don't forget to tag us in your creations on Instagram and Facebook. We love to see them. Also, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button on the video and subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. Until next time, happy crafting. Bye-bye.